Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Kirby's Epic Yarn. Last time we went through, I think, Treatland and Beachland, I believe. And now we're gonna go through the Snow World, so... That's a great start. That works, I guess. But, I remember this being one of my, favourite worlds in the game, and... Most of that has to do with me just loving ice and snow levels. Like, they're not exactly the same thing, but they have a similar aesthetic, and I kind of just bundle them as the same basic kind of theme. The major difference with snow and ice is just the ice physics are less prevalent in just snow levels, but you know, I just always like looking at snow in games, and it just always had that nice, cheery feeling to them. Like, I understand why people don't like ice levels too much, but I've always liked them. They have a special place in my heart, and they're just fun. I can't really tell you exactly why, but I've always just enjoyed the level design in these kind of stages, even if the physics can be a little bit annoying sometimes. Like, I think Ridestar was like one of the best games for using like the ice physics in a unique way, because it basically used it as a actual platforming challenge instead of just a regular obstacle like you'd usually see. And yeah, I mean, I'm mostly fine with ice physics. Like, there's like a few games I played where it can be kind of annoying. I can't think of them off the top of my head right now, but there are a few games I played where they can be a little bit irritating, but like I said, worst kind of gameplay will always be that was a fail. Yeah, the worst gameplay will always be auto-scrollers for me. Like, there's nothing that can change that. Like, I can count on one hand how the amount of auto-scrollers I like, which would be... I shouldn't have done that. The Rayman Legends music levels, the levels in Rayman Legends that... Basically, it's like when you go to the Land of the Living Dead, and you you have to do like this, you have to keep running, and you have like really fast-paced challenges. Like, the challenge there is to keep on your toes and make sure you don't like fall asleep on the controller or whatever. Like, you have to be focusing at all times. And the auto scrolling is basically just there, so you can't just go back and try again. It's like, it's basically a marathon, especially for the daily, weekly challenges, which I really enjoyed those. Like, when it was like Land of the Living Dead, see how far you can get. Those were some of my favorite challenges in that game. And yeah, there's that. And then there's a Sky Chase Zone from Sonic 2. Yeah, those three things are the only things I can think of that where I actively like playing those kinds of stages. Other than that, I don't think I can get up there from there. Do I go back? So it feels like if I just go down here, I'm just gonna miss a load of stuff. I guess we'll find out. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to replay the level. We missed something for sure. We've had to. Like, had to have missed something. There's no way. Yeah, Yeah, I do like how this world has, like, especially later on. Oh, wait, could I have jumped on the other ones? Let's see if it goes back far enough. No, it's just this. Oh. Maybe the CD is further on. Maybe we can still get everything. We'll have to, like, not lose any beads, though. Right. That's a good start. I don't think so. Alright. Yeah, I doubt we're gonna get this. The CD was probably back there. Very nice music as well. Oh! Okay. Oh! Well, we're definitely gonna have to replay it to get the gold, but... I don't think we can get it from just this, can we? Nah. Nowhere near. Alright. At least we found everything. Nice. Oh, this is the Christmas-themed one, I think. Alright. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Alright, now it's time to go back. Well, no, well, we haven't been here, so not go back, but we're gonna go to Cozy Cabin, and this is basically, in the stereo Christmas theme, like, you have these Christmas-like trees that have the bees basically make it look like it's decorated, and I'm assuming there's gonna be a star at the top, right? Oh, just that. Well, okay. That works too, I guess. Did I miss anything? Nope. But yeah, like, you're basically gonna be like Santa in this level. Basically just go down the chimneys and go through a house, and I want to get that guy. Hey kiddies! And yeah, you're gonna be getting crushed. So kind of like it's kind of like the subspace areas in Return to Dreamland, or whatever you want to call them. And well, it's a lot more calm, as you can tell from the music alone. But yeah, you still don't want to dilly dally too much. So just get what you need, go out. It just kind of repeats and gets harder every time, so... Oh, now it's a star. That's more like it. Who puts a circle X thing on their tray? Like... But yeah, I really like this level. Well... As the name goes, it's a very cozy feeling. It doesn't... Well, I mean... Can I even make it up there anymore? Nah. I don't think the car gives you any extra height. Maybe I can glitch up there. Screw it. We already have a gold. So... I'm really wasting time right now. Wait. No! Wait! I don't know if there was stuff down there. I can't see anything of worth, so I'm gonna hope that we didn't miss a treasure or anything. Come on! No! Right. Touching the thing should not equal, like, death. Alright, we got the treasure. But we need to really get beads back. We should be able to get enough. Like, we can easily get it from just the end thing, but... Yeah, that's kind of silly, like, how it... You just touch it and... It should, like, have it so you at least get crushed. But, oh well. I mean... I honestly thought that... the black stuff in the... weird alternate dimension areas in Kirby Wii would kill you. If you just touched them, but... No, they're a bit more lenient than that. And to be fair, sometimes you end up, like, having to touch it, and there's not a lot you can do about it, so I guess it makes it fair. No, it just makes it feel weird on, like, the first couple sections, but then you understand. Very nice. Very easy to get the gold in this. Like, The other stage was actually pretty strict. Like, I think what I had to do to get to that upper section was to ride the snowball, but since I killed the Waddle Dee, I couldn't do that, so... Yeah. I just rip him. Now, where is that CD at? It's there. Come on. I'm not sure if we're running on a timer with this one, but... That should be the end. Yep. Yep, full row. It's like a film reel. Very nice. Spool. You can wait. yeah, this snowman just gets smaller and smaller, which is kind of cool, I guess. Mount slide. Oh, is this a penguin slide? Because that would be really cool. Pun not intended. I mean, it kind of just happens. Play with my gamer instincts. Alright. Ooh, okay. One more. Yes! Oh man, that was kinda wonky, but hey, that worked. Come on! No, that was bad! Alright, oh whatever. We got the stuffs. Getting all the stages. I'm not sure what this level is. Frosty Will. It's kind of funny how this is basically, well, so far it's the only world that follows. Oh, that's a cool little detail. When it's like icy, you have like a sled thing. That's kind of cool. But what is it? The this is the only world so far where it's followed as a specific theme, whereas the others kind of do whatever. And I mean, it's kind of a little bit weird, but hey, I like snow levels, so I'm all for it. I'm cool with it being the exception. I was just thinking about it, actually. I believe this next world keeps the same theme going on throughout the entire level, entire world even. Nope. I hate seeing all those stars going down like that. This is like a game where I feel really bad for falling into a pit. Like, other games are like, why, and all that. But this one is like, oh wow, I just wasted so many beads. It sucks. Yeah, this one's kind of unremarkable. It's not too much going on here. Aside from me getting frozen every 2 seconds. Alright, that's more like it. Don't fall. And that's the CD, right? Yep, it is. Alright, now we just need to get enough beads. We're gonna have to replay the level again, aren't we? Oh, wait. Can I do this? Oh, I can. Woo! There's stuff there. Come on, Kirby, what are you doing? No! Why? Like, they're just like, oh, it's Kirby, even though I can't get up to him. It's like, rip. I keep doing it too early. Or too late. Rather, wait, I can just do it from like this. Very nice. Alright. Cool, cool, cool. Oh, okay, we got it. Okay. Just don't fall. Then we'll be good. Oh! No! Are you serious? We've lost it. There's no way. That is so trash. Look, we're not even gonna get from this. No, didn't even get 5-star. Oh, okay, we did. Oh my gosh, barely. Wow. That's clutch if I've ever seen it. Now you're gonna see a very familiar face. Ooh. It's an interesting way to have like the Aurora Borealis, or however you pronounce it. Right, it's time for some King Dedede! I actually really like the rendition of his theme in this game. Alright. So it kind of acts a little more similar to actually no, it's still pretty different, but yeah, he had like stars pop up when he used the hammer, so it has a few things that are like regular Kirby bosses, which is kind of cool. Oh gosh, I forgot if that was like you had to get like jump straight away, or is it, or it was a shockwave. I don't feel comfortable being over here. Yeah, that's how you get normal stars. Or beads. Yeah, I just love this theme so much. Who doesn't? It's definitely one of my favorite renditions, actually. Like, this and Brawl are definitely my favorites. Kirby, Return to Dreamland is pretty good, too. Oh yeah, especially like there's Master Yuzu in Triple Deluxe as well. That was fantastic. Alright, you're not gonna do any more hammer attacks, are you? Okay, I don't wanna hit him normally, because come and get out of the way. Alright, I need you to do the hammer one more time. Can you do that for me? Please be a pal. I don't want you to be NTSC. I mean, pal didn't get Dream Collection. Don't be like that, please. Oh, come on. I can't believe that didn't disappear. Alright, I'm gonna have to wait for another cycle again. Can I take those? Oh, wow! Okay, then. Alright, we can do it now. Oh, wait, I need to pound him. Oops. Okay, that's good to know. I didn't know you could actually take the shockwave things. But I can take him out. He's done. Wait, did it just collect all the beads for me? Did that count? Oh well.
We did it! We got a piece of the magic yarn. The magic yarn shimmered and spiraled and swirled high into the sky.
Yep, it's not hard to tell what that world's gonna be about.
The yarn weaved its way into the fabric of the kingdom and stitched two pieces of Patchland together. Meanwhile, in the sky above Dreamland. On the battleship Halberd, Meta Knight have noticed some odd changes in the landscape. Patches and stitching everywhere. What monster would do such a thing? Just then, a powerful laugh filled the sky around him. What? Who goes there? Yin Yang crashed onto the deck and completely ambushed Meta Knight. Mind if I sock it to you? And just like that, Meta Knight was gone. Now Yin Yan had Dreamland all to himself. With Yin Yan's victory all sewn up, did this mean the end of Dreamland?